Mission: What happened in a trauma room, next Sunday at 9 on Channel 5 and My5.
Two weeks into lockdown, all of our lives were changed beyond recognition.
Everything about that period of time feels bonkers. I was bleaching my groceries.
You'd had that rush of panic buying, people stocking up on whatever they could grab, particularly toilet rolls.
Teaching our children at home, doing Zoom classroom calls. We didn't even know what Zoom was at that particular moment in time.
You did get stir crazy. My friends and I, we were doing all that stuff, you know, quizzes on Zoom was ridiculous. And I was talking to people for longer than I normally would just because I was sick of talking to my husband. We'd run out by that point of stuff to say.
I would think a lot of dogs got more walks than they ever had in their lives because husbands or wives just wanted to get away.
There was also this community spirit that was out there. We were, you know, we were clapping for the NHS.
We made the decision to launch our first ever national appeal for the NHS. Hundreds of thousands of people had started to fundraise in their own homes, doing virtual runs, walking, baking, camping out. And one of those people was Captain Tom.
I'm not sure if I remember specifically when I first heard about Captain Tom. I think he just sort of slowly infiltrated into my life.
It kind of started with a 99-year-old man who decides that he wants to do 100 laps of his garden.
At the time, he was living with his daughter, Hannah, and Hannah's husband, Colin, and their two children.
He was due to have a large birthday party. That had to be cancelled because of the pandemic. The suggestion came up that he do 100 laps of the garden for charity.
They said, every lap you do of the garden, we'll give you £1 for charity. And he was like, challenge accepted. And they thought, hey, why not make this a Just Giving page?
Captain Tom's grandson, Benji, got on Twitter and started tweeting people saying, this is what my granddad's doing. And then it was picked up by the media. And yeah, it snowballed.
What began as small features in local papers and radio stations escalated to national news.
The incredible story of a one-man fundraising machine, veteran Captain Tom Moore.
If you're looking for hope and inspiration during these dark days, then search no further than 99-year-old Captain Tom Moore.
I hope people will give some money to this fund. Not for me, but for their national health.
This kind, gentle, unassuming, courageous, elderly man rose phoenix-like out of all our misery.
He was the perfect hero. A military bloke, a classic British gentleman. This was Sergeant Wilson from Dad's Army meets Pudsey the Bear.
It's lovely, isn't it? A nice warm day.
But what nobody anticipated was the extraordinary response from the locked-down British public.
The money went up, like, exponentially fast.
So originally he wanted £100 that he was just going to get from his family. That escalated to £1,000. Fast forward a week, he was making millions. Every single day there'd be another £3 million added to the pot.
Seeing the numbers growing every day, it passed £1 million, then it passed several million. It was just incredible.
I'm just looking at a headline here that we wrote on the 15th of April. I put the amount in the headlines. 7.5 million, correct at time of going to press, because almost by the time you've hit publish, it would have changed.
Here was a celebrity that had been born through supporting charity and supporting the NHS.
By doing this, 99-year-old Captain Tom Moore has now raised more than £8 million for the NHS.
This man was doing all this to save our National Health Service. How could you not be taken with that.
The money raised by his sponsored walks around his garden in Bedfordshire will pass the £10 million mark any minute now.
It was certainly something that made us feel valued and cherished, especially when he was one of those people who was highly vulnerable to COVID-19. If he can do this, then I can get through this as well.
The good wishes from so many people really is quite outstanding. It's mind-breaking, really.
The royals, William and Kate, they were sending him congratulatory messages.
It's wonderful that everyone kind of is being inspired by his story and his determination.
I think Catherine Jenkins went to visit him. There were messages from David Becker, from David Jason, from the Prime Minister.
If we as a country can show the same spirit of optimism and energy shown by Captain Tom Moore.
A success attracts success, so everyone wanted a bit of Captain Tom. They wanted to be associated with him, whether you were David Beckham or whether you were Prince Harry, whether you were Carol Vorderman.
Well, Captain Tom Moore has now raised more than $42 million for health workers in the UK.
He was a global sensation. Everybody in the world was talking about him.
He got Britain, he got France, he got the US, Australia. He went around the world. He was in the news, in the newspapers. He was just aiming to capture Bedfordshire.
There were 160 countries where people donated. This was the reach of this man.
He was mentioned in a speech by the Japanese emperor. He was everywhere. He was like Taylor Swift and Beyonce without quite as much stagecraft.
A bit like a whirlwind or even a tsunami. Suddenly it gained such strength. And you wonder just how far it could go. And of course, it went from a few thousand to tens of millions of pounds. He caught the mood like no one else.
Captain Tom's achievements were putting his sleepy village, Marston Mortain, on the map.
It just caught the imagination at the right time. Something we needed. I think the whole flipping country needed it.
Many of the villagers, like myself, just felt so proud. I just think it was a real inspiration.
I remember the first time I interviewed Captain Tom, and he was the most gracious man and so grateful for the attention, so grateful for the money that he was raising.
I don't think he realised the impact of what he was doing. And I don't think he realised the extent of the reach that he had.
There was a kind of innocence, simplicity, selflessness and courage that you don't get to see very often these days. He was the nation's granddad.
One thing that we can't resist as a nation is a vulnerable former war hero who is now an elderly man. I'm bad for it too. Whenever I see the Remembrance Day parade, I cry.
That Second World War generation are the greatest generation. It's like, ah, there's the Blitz spirit right there. And he's in lockdown like us. And what's he doing, even though he's nearly 100? He's walking around his garden for other people.
But COVID wasn't the first time Captain Tom had had a taste of the limelight.
Obviously, when someone reaches this level of prominence, journalists and TV companies, they want to go back and see what they can find out. The most exciting thing they could come up with was that he'd been on Blankety Blank.
And here's your host on Terry Wogan.
Tom, what's your name?
Moore.
Tom Moore. How are the melodies?
Oh, fine.
That's good. And where are you from?
Tipsend.
It was a Christmas edition and he was there. He looks just like the boss out of The Good Life.
Tom, have you got family or anybody you'd rather not be watching this?
Yes, I've got two girls.
Yes.
Coming up 16, coming up 14.
Too old for this rubbish.
He gave a stoic performance, but it was only enough to win the signature checkbook and pen.
He's living a life, really, like most of us would have lived our lives. And I think that ordinariness is what endeared him to people.
But he was about to reach even more extraordinary heights. Three weeks into his fundraiser, Captain Tom reached number one with a rousing rendition of You'll Never Walk Alone, alongside Michael Ball and a choir of NHS heroes.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high. And don't be afraid of the dark.
When I heard that he was doing a single with Michael Ball, I thought this has probably got out of the realms of normality.
Michael sounded like he's a professional singer.
Walk on with hope.
And you'll
never walk. Tom sounded like a, you know, a retired soldier. You know, you'd expect him to. It was very moving. And you'll never
walk alone. Makes Captain Tom the oldest person in Britain ever to have a number one. He's overtaken Tom Jones. I don't think he's as good a singer as Tom Jones, but there we are.
It was just very, very bizarre. Very, very bizarre. You'll never walk
alone. At that point, it started to take on a sort of celebrity. It felt like a real... Somebody had come in as a manager. Somebody had come in and said, here's how we make you more famous.
Captain Tom was now doing up to 30 interviews a day for press from right around the world.
Pretty much on every interview he did, he always had a member of his family there, predominantly Hannah, his daughter.
Captain Tom wouldn't have achieved the success he did without his daughter, Hannah, at his side, pushing the PR, arranging the interviews. The PR was clever. They were smart, they knew what they were doing. And to see him with his medals gave him that added advantage, because it did, it pulled at your heartstrings.
We spoke with him on three occasions, and every time you started with the daughter and then you were put through to Dad. But now, as a result of the stories, I'm not saying it was a fact, but you can ask, did she want to kind of assert herself, ally herself with him and his achievements?
What we saw was Tom walking around his garden doing TV interviews. What we didn't see was how the family were looking after him behind the scenes.
Why don't you sit down?
So any TV interviews or activity finished at 2 p.m. for the day. They tried to keep things normal for him and to make sure that he didn't get too overwhelmed.
I don't know why anyone would criticise Hannah for being with him while he was being interviewed. There was partly just a hearing thing. His hearing wasn't great. And I do think that the fact that people criticise her for being by his side gives a clue to something else that's going on here. And I think it's an instinct that we have in this country particularly, where no sooner has this perfect story been created than somebody's going to attack it with a sledgehammer.
But the criticism would grow into something bigger and much more serious.
The day that Captain Tom went to number one with his charitable single, Hannah Ingram Moore and her husband Colin founded their business called Club Nook Limited. And I think that's the beginning of where all the real trouble started.